How you doing, guys? Gals? How's everything going? It's Jake here from Jake and Dar. Ooh, yeah, that was a great one.
Yeah.
Sure was, eh? Right on. Okay. And I'm gonna do a review tonight, right here on live again, on Justin TV. And I've got this to review tonight. This is the Bottle Brew. Can't see it, eh? That's the Bottle Brew, and it's a 2-liter bottle of wort that's basically already done up for you, and all you do is drop a yeast pill into it and let it ferment for 2 weeks, and then you chill it for 12 hours, and then you drink it. Apparently it's just as simple as that, so, okay. Now I've seen another guy on here on YouTube that did a video on this, and I'm not going to mention his username, because I just won't. But, you know, he did it, and he thought it was okay. He thought it was okay, to his opinion. I'm gonna try to open this with my, just with my hand here. Maybe I don't need the tool. See if this will open up. Oh yeah, here we go. Listen to this. Oh, not much of a hiss there. It's a little bit cloudy. It didn't clear up that much. Bottle's a... Yeah. Well, it's out of shot. Yeah, I know. I'm doing it for the camera, though. Because I'm doing this, I'm going to be posting this on YouTube. So I want to adjust the camera over here, too. I'm sorry, but I'll pour it up right here. I don't know how the hell you pour this goddamn big thing. But it's squishing it. It's slippery, too. Okay, here goes the pour. Ready? I'm going to pour it up anyways, see what happens. The old Bottle Brew. See what we got here. Not much of a head on that. By the way, this is a Pilsner. And now I'm stuck. Oh no, this ought to be good. How am I going to set these friggers down? I'm stuck. Got my hands both at the bottom. Oh, you gotta like this, guys. You gotta like this. I got myself stuck. Dummy. Yeah, dummy. Okay. Let's carry on with this. I spilt a little teeny bit on my mat there. Oh, well. Okay, well, I don't know. It looks all right. Oh, the friggin' sirens again. How about that? It's a bit on the dark side. Can't really see through it. Yeah, it's a bit dark, eh? See that? It's a bit dark. Oh, well. Let's give it a try. Doesn't seem like it's overly carbonated, but let's give it a nose here. It smells okay. It doesn't smell great, but it's a premium Pilsner, it says. Let's give it a try. Not sure what to think of that. I don't know. It's okay, I guess. Well, it has that Pilsner taste, but it... Mm-hmm. It has that Pilsner taste, but it also has another kind of taste that's... I can't really explain it. It's kind of like an average homebrew taste. I don't know how to explain a homebrew taste, but... Yeah... I don't know. I mean, it's got that refreshingness. It's fairly carbonated for... It doesn't look that carbonated, but... It's decently carbonated. As you can tell... See? I'd have to say it's not too bad. I don't know. I can't tell you what it tastes like. It just tastes, I don't know, I can't really pinpoint what other beer it's close to. It's really hard to say. No, it's not my cup of tea. No. Okay, yeah, it's not bad. It's decent. I can't say that it's horrible. I won't say it's horrible. I won't say it's bad, okay? It's not a gross beer. It's not, I don't know, it's not like a good Cooper's beer. Yeah, and I said a good Cooper's beer. It just tastes like an average everyday Pilsner, decently carbonated Pilsner. Somewhere along the lines something like an old Milwaukee, actually. Okay, it's like an old Milwaukee, okay? This is almost like an old Milwaukee. And I'm going to finish this old Milwaukee. No, it's similar to the old Milwaukee. I guess that's probably the closest comparison. But it's probably, I would have to say it's equal or maybe even a little bit better than an old Milwaukee, because an old Milwaukee's not that great. At least not in my books. I don't really like old Milwaukee that much. It just tastes like maybe it was fermenting, and also, again, maybe this was fermenting in too high of a temperature, so the flavor didn't come out real great, so it's kind of like a little bit, you know, down on the scale, the flavor sort of situation. I'm really messing up this review, aren't I? I'm not doing a very good job here, guys. You gotta help me out. Come on, guys. You gotta help me out with this. You gotta tell me how this tastes, man. You just gotta look at it and say, yeah, that tastes exactly like that. Oh, well. I don't know. It tastes good. It's good, but it's not great. Again, if I were to rate this bottle brew, this Big and Easy bottle brew, I'd have to fit it right in somewhere around the 3 out of 5 scale. So a little bit better than midway, a little bit better than average. It's drinkable, put it that way. It's going to be drinkable because I'm going to get rid of it. Yeah, back to the tunes, eh? Eh? I said eh? Okay, thanks for watching, you guys. Appreciate that very much. I'm really, really happy that you stopped in and checked this messed up review out, and I'm going to get back to this live broadcast here, and I'll catch you guys later.